Hey everyone, I'm Aliana and welcome back to my channel. Today I would like to share three things that you cannot learn from an online UX design course or a UX design bootcamp. For those of you who are still learning about UX design, I hope this video can help you to prepare early. And for those of you who are already working as a UX designer, I hope you find this video relatable. The first thing is how to design on the spot. What I mean by that, it's you going to a Zoom meeting and there are five other people waiting for you, and somehow in the middle of the meeting, somebody says, "Hey Aliana, can you share your screen?" and then realize what we just said. This happens to me almost every single day, and it's definitely pretty frightening during the first few times. Well, because everyone is waiting for me and literally looking at my screen, wait for me to realize their design. And, you know, in a bootcamp or in an online course, you won't share your screen while designing. So there's no like social pressure there. And my biggest tip for you when you go into this situation is, first, don't panic. And second, don't try to make a perfect design. This is not a place to justify your design skill. I just remember this one time where I couldn't find the check icon in the design system that we have. And then somehow, in the middle of the meeting, I was just like, let me show everyone my perfect UI design skill and how I can design a great check icon from scratch. It was literally just a green circle with a white check icon. I don't know why, I just screwed up in the middle. So everyone in this meeting room was like waiting for me for 2 minutes, looking at me, trying to shrink down an icon and couldn't make it right. That was so embarrassing. Yeah. So when it comes to sharing your screen in a Zoom meeting and try to realize all other people and your idea, just bring out a wireframe with some placeholder text. That's good enough. You can make it perfect after the Zoom call, but not during the Zoom call. And a few other tips for this one. First, close those wrong tabs and make sure to share the right screen. The second thing happens to me every day. If you are using a monitor, sharing a screen from your monitor, think about the people who will be, you know, looking at this screen and using their phone. Zoom in and make sure everyone can see the screen. Another thing that will definitely happen to you as a UX designer is working within constraints. There are so many constraints, and it's absolutely normal to have constraints. But the key is to understand the constraints early on so that you don't waste time designing for nothing. There are a few constraints type that I faced on a daily basis. The first one is having no resource for user testing. If your company doesn't provide any resource for user testing, then you still need to have a way to justify your design decisions. You can do more research, you can see what are other competitors doing, or you can do some internal testings, which is pretty much just asking whoever you know in the company as a mock design interview. Another type of constraint is engineering constraint. That is an engineer going to you and say that, "Sorry, we cannot do that." It's absolutely normal, and the best way to deal with this constraint is to ask early on. Don't bring a finished product after 3 months of iteration to the engineers, and then they say, "Oh, sorry, I cannot do it." Then what have you been working on for the 3 months? Make sure you bring them a wireframe or just an early work and ask them whether they can make it or not. It's much better to avoid this kind of problem early on. The third type of constraint is product constraint. Product constraint is when leaderships or product owners come to you and say, "Sorry, our product has to do this. It has to do that. It has to have this button here." Again, it's also always better to know this early on, but sometimes you might be able to argue with them why you are making a design decision, not the other. My way to do it is always ask them why we are doing it. Sometimes we can come up with a better approach to solve the root problem instead of sticking what they want in their mind. And the fourth one is one that I neglected for a while. It is legal constraint. I personally don't know much about laws. But apparently, if you're designing a product for the European market, then there's way stricter laws when it comes to how to design product. Usually, if you are being as ethical as possible with your design, you should be good. But there are still few cases where you are being ethical, you think you're doing everything right, but there are still few things you need to tweak because of legal reason. So just keep that in mind as well. The third thing I want to share today is document your work. You won't learn this from a design bootcamp or from a design course, but it's so important to document your work. Just imagining you being hired to a design position, but the previous designer left her job, so she hand over to you a few design files that are just halfway done. You go into these files, everything is everywhere. You go to the archive page, you just see those random screens. You have no idea what they've tried before and why they did certain design iterations. This has happened to me, and I don't want it to happen to you or other people. Documenting your work will make your life way easier, make other people's life easier, level up your career, and also help you so much when it comes to building your design portfolio. I actually have a dedicated video on this topic here, so make sure to check it out. But in short, don't delete everything you've tried. And second, don't just put random stuff into the archive page. Make sure you give a few annotations on why you tried this approach and why you didn't use this approach. Again, as a UI UX designer, our job is not just on the visual level. We are being hired to make design decisions for our users and our company under design constraints. So, I hope you find this video helpful. If you want to see the part 2 of this video, please comment a victory sign emoji in the comment section below. I still have a lot that I can share. And also don't forget to follow me on my social media, Instagram especially, and subscribe to my YouTube, comment, share, do whatever you can. Thank you so much. As always, thank you so much and see you next time.